David, talking to the guys in the room after, they made note of how you urged them to stay the course. So obviously, were there enough reasons in their game to stay the course despite being down?
Without question. I mean, one of the things we talked about is don't play the score. I thought that we did a lot of good things in that first period. I mean, you know, it was frustrating getting out of that first period 3-0 because, boy, I thought we had some great chances. We played at a pace. We played with a little bit of physicality. Even after the fourth goal, I mean, you know, during one of the timeouts, it's all we kept saying on the bench, and we just never stopped. I mean, we just never stopped, and I couldn't be prouder of these guys, the way we competed from the drop of the puck to the way to the horn blowing at the end after 60 minutes. And, you know, give our goalie a lot of credit. I mean, he had a tough beginning, but, boy, did he battle back and stood tall when we needed him to be. But just, I mean, from our goalie to our decor to our forwards, I mean, just a real team effort.
The physicality was pretty impressive in all three zones, really, from the get-go.
Yeah, we were dialed in. We were, you know, this is a fast game in a small area, and if you're not engaged in contact, you're not going to have success. And, you know, not only that, just the way we played. I mean, we played at a pace. There wasn't much screwing around with the puck in the neutral zone. We turned it up. There was a pace to our game that we're going to need to have success. And just you could feel the passion, even at 4-0. I mean, guys never wavered. They never felt like we were out of it. And just really a great win and a great effort.
And for a guy who's paid the price physically and the way he looks, Brandon, it's nice to have him score a couple.
I'd like to give him another black guy for that too many men on the ice, but he played too well, so I won't do that. But listen, I've talked about him a lot. I mean, I love him as a player. He's a great kid. He works hard. He's everything you want in a hockey player, and I'm happy for him that he got rewarded statistically.
Did you at any time, David, think about pulling it to Alex?
Yes.
And was that after the third goal, after the first period, after the fourth goal?
The fourth one.
Did you just not like that goal?
Couple things. We made it 4-1. You know, one of the things I was thinking, you bring Hank in, you might ignite the crowd. You know, it's a little dramatic when you bring a guy in this building because he's got to come through the tunnel and there's a big hoopla bringing him in. I didn't want to do that. Then we got the second one, and I thought Georgie started settling down. But there were a lot of reasons why I didn't do it. Certainly we had Hank warming up. We had Hank ready to go. But, you know, once we got the first one and then the second and things started settling in, I just thought, you know, the last thing I want to do is bring Hank in and get the crowd all riled up. And that was part of the thought process.
That was once you started getting goals, but at 4-0.
Yes, I had him getting ready to go. Yes. Yeah, I chose not to because of that reason. I thought, I want him ready to go, and I was just kind of feeling it. And, you know, I just thought of the crowd. You know, you bring him in, it's 4-0, the place goes cuckoo, and, you know, all of a sudden it ignites everything. So I wanted to avoid bringing him in at all costs.
Just a few hours ago, you said that this team hasn't responded well to early adversity, and now after the early adversity tonight, just in the lens of that, what can you say about that?
Well, you can't really create more adversity for yourself than being down 4-0 in Montreal to the Canadiens. And we don't do anything half-hearted, I'll tell you that. When we stink, we stink. When we're good, we're good. And when we fight through adversity, we say, we're going to fight through adversity. And we didn't tiptoe around it.
You could go down the list, but Chris Kreider from that first shift when he puts that hit on Armia, and then he makes that play to answer the 5-3 goal. I mean, what did he mean to staying the course?
He was outstanding. He was dialed in on the ice. He was dialed in off the ice. And you know, he means so much to our team, and I'm really happy for him because he gave everything he had on and off the ice. He was pivotal on the bench, and just a great effort by Chris.
Do you feel like you're learning something about the resolve of this team with so many young players that haven't experienced these ups and downs? Do you feel like they're showing you something with games like this?
Without question. Obviously, you know, there's a lot of things, I've said this before, that goes into winning. And talent, obviously, one of them. But you better have resolve. You better have mental toughness. You better have conditioning. You better have leadership. You better fight through adversity. And we showed all of that tonight.
The thought process behind putting Shea back with Trouba, did you like what you saw from them?
I thought Brady Shea had a monster game. I thought, you know, Trouba was a monster tonight. I loved both their games tonight.
Just any reason behind making that change now? I know you had it for the first game and then you went away from it.
Yeah, I just thought, you know, it's been a while and, you know, I didn't love what I saw last night on anybody. And I was thinking about change. Obviously, we changed the lines during the game, but just something I wanted to do. I wanted to put those two together.
I don't want to get nuts because you were behind the bench for a comeback in a national title game, but where does this rank in your
experience? Obviously, it's up there. And for a variety of reasons, you know, it's just, I like coaching this team so much, and to see their, how excited they were after we won, and the way, and what they put into it on and off the ice, it just, it's a great feeling to watch them enjoy the moment, you know, because when you come in this building, you're down 4-0, and you accomplish what we just accomplished, they should feel really good about it. I'm happy for them.